Hello and welcome back to yet another Black Ops 4 video. In today's video, we're going to recap the Treyarch Blackout Studio livestream. They did not show any gameplay, but we got a lot of cool info, so let's just get into it. As a reminder, the Blackout beta will be available this Monday, September 10th at 10 a.m. Pacific, and the beta will only be available on PS4, that is, until Friday, September 14th. Friday, September 14th, 10 a.m. Pacific, the Blackout beta will be expanded to include PC and Xbox One, and PS4 will continue to be able to play it. And finally, PC players will also get the chance to try out the game completely free. So the PC open beta will be available starting Saturday, September 15th, 10 a.m. Pacific on Battle.net. I'll have all this, everything I'm going to talk about will be in the description. New info we know. So, waiting lobby. As you know, in PUBG, you guys sit around and you walk around. In Fortnite, same thing. You sit around on the island. Well, in Blackout, they throw you in there as if it's a real game. You can pick up items, go hunting, kill each other. It's essentially like the actual game, but none of the kills count. So that's pretty fun. You can immediately warm up and have some fun there, explore. Now, as in the trailer, they show the choppers. So yes, they did confirm that is how you drop in. Each squad gets its chopper, and as we said before, your wingsuit stays on you at all times. You can base jump off of anything of a decent height. You start out by sprinting and then you press and hold the jump button. And just like a real jumpsuit, you can actually fly upwards for a while. So if you build up enough momentum, you can fly up to maybe fly up onto a rooftop, or you can use that as a way to air brake to slow yourself down. Let's say you see a squad in the distance and you're like, oh, I don't want to go there. You can use your air brake, go up, and use that as a way to avoid them. So remember that bag? I don't know what it was when it dropped. That actually turns out to be your gear. You kill someone, they drop a duffel bag, and you can, you know, go over there and loot it, see what weapons and gear they had. So talking about gear, attachments, weapon attachments can be found across the map, very much like PUBG. And keep in mind, some attachments won't work with certain weapons. So kind of like PUBG, pretty much. You will need the correct ammo for each gun. And you know, that's nothing crazy. That's just like, you know, Fortnite does that. So basically, when you run across ammo, pick it up. There will be lethal and tactical equipments, and you will need to find those. You won't spawn in with them. And there's going to be rare items. This is specialist based equipment. So the example they used was Battery's grenade launcher. All right, so you find her grenade launcher, and you actually will need to use that to unlock maybe a skin, a challenge, some kind of reward. Von der Haar was very kind of vague on it. But basically, he said, if you want to unlock certain skins for certain characters, you will need to pick up their weapon. So if you want to unlock something for Battery, the girl that uses the grenade launcher, you will need to pick up her weapon and get X amount of kills, and then you get one of her special skins. So in the trailer, we did see an RC car. Turns out that's not an RC car. That's a recon car. Recon car does not explode. It doesn't kill people. It's basically used to get intel, kind of like R6, right? You have the little drone you pilot around and you tell your teammates what you see. Same concept. So recon car, not an RC car. Von der Haar was kind of dropping little hints. He said there's going to be a classic World at War weapon in Blackout. So maybe some of you Zombies fans can maybe drop some hints. And speaking of Von der Haar being vague, someone tweeted him this. They said, you mentioned that the map maybe took place in Northern California, but why does this car have from Raid have an EU license plate? And Von D actually tweeted back at him, maybe it's trying to tell you something important. What could it be telling us? I don't know. I don't look that into it. I just can't wait to play the game. Zombies. Zombies will only spawn in zombie-themed areas. So we saw in the trailer, there's Asylum from World at War. So the zombie-themed areas that you guys know are zombies maps, there will be zombies there that will attack you, but there will be a chance at better loot. So it's going to be a trade-off. Do you want to jump in to a zombies infested area, no weapons, no nothing, in the chance of getting a loot? And keep in mind, other players will have that same mindset. So you'll have a bunch of people just jumping into Asylum, and everyone's going to battle for the guns. And if you don't get no weapons, you'll have to deal with players with weapons and zombies coming after you. So that's going to be pretty fun. The vehicles will have unlimited fuel. So, you know, in PUBG, you gotta have, I think in PUBG, you need fuel, right? You need gas. They said in this game, it moves so fast. They didn't need to add it. So you can fly the helicopter as much as you like. Never need to worry about maintenance on it. That does sound a little imbalanced. So I'm thinking once it takes damage, you can't heal it. I don't know. I'm just kind of assuming for balancing purposes. We'll find out soon. Vaughn also stated that they're going to try different player counts in the beta, like 3 on a team or 5 on a team. He's going to tweak it every day as we get feedback. So it's not really set in stone. You know, I'm sure there's going to be solo, of course, duos, squads, but how big will the squad be? And that's what they were saying. 3, 4, 5. 5-man could be a good fun size. That could be a very fun party. I am very excited. I'm trying to keep my hype levels in check, but in Treyarch we trust, man. I am so excited. I can't wait. Again, links to all this stuff down below. Charlie Intel did a great recap of the stuff. I just, recap the stuff that I think you guys really care about. And yes, I will be posting the Blackout content. I'll be streaming it on my Twitch. Links to that down below. And in case you missed it, on the left side there is the Epic Moments of the Week and Call of Duty. We will be updating that as BO4 drops, and on the right, a brand new video.